Yeah, did you read this?
Okay, well, you need time to break that.
Can I help you at all? Anyone want a ticket? You gotta move on because I'm busy finding my nails.
How can I help?
Would you like a ticket? Not in this booth. I'm busy finding my nails. Hello, sir. Can I help you? Sir, can I help you?
Can I help
you? You don't want a ticket then. Okay. You move on. Hello?
Say standard.
Would you not in this book, honey? You're gonna have to move on. I'm busy following my nails.
Can I help you?
Yes, it's a
sorry,
you are open, yes please. Hello.
I'm afraid that we no longer have any tickets. You will have to wait on the platform for the next train. Thank you.
Waiting with bated breath.
London is the greatest city in the world.
Stand the streets for one or two nights. They might survive. They can't. It's not nice in streets. It's very, very lucky in streets, man. That look at show 24/7 days a week.
yes, yes. I do admit there is a problem with housing in London. But what we must focus on, it is the fault of the previous government, and no blame can lie with us.
Guys, can we just drop all of this poverty crap, yeah? It's really boring. If people cared, it wouldn't be an issue, would it?
Okay, so I'll take 2 cheeseburgers, 2 Happy Meals, 5 milkshakes, almost in the flurry, please.
I do understand what you're saying. We are 40% under target in terms of building homes in London. But again, we must focus on the fact it is the fault of the previous government, and no blame can lie with us.
Guys, come on, it's just so depressing, and I want you all to realise, yeah? Smiles sell me papers.
It's £20 going to London tonight. I'll take 6 tickets,
please. Enough!
A politician. Media holder. The tourist. All this money she just puts it to waste. All this power he gives with one hand, takes with the other. All this influence is tap, 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 bollocks. I was like them. Really, I was, but I lost it all.
It is time for you to stop.
Boom!
All of your sobbing.
Boom!
Yes, it's time for you to stop.
Boom!
All of your sobbing.
Boom!
If there's one thing you gotta do,
boom,
to make me still want you,
gotta stop sobbing now.
Oh, no, my dear, don't look to the right.
Did you know that London has the largest number of super rich people in the world?
In fact, there are 4,363 of us that have over 20 million in the bank. And you, my dear, well, you look like one of us.
Oh, no. You don't look like one of them. You look like one of us 72 billionaires. 10% of the world's billionaires that live right here in London. Even our closest rival, Moscow, has only 48.
That's enough! Honestly, if I saw myself on that side, I'd kick myself to this side too. I mean, I was one of London's richest, London's finest, the magic 4363, but like I told you, I lost it all. London's billionaires. You see her? She was my beautiful model wife. And him? My adorable son. Darling, please, take a seat. I'm so sorry.
I'm not happy, Mark. And I need to get back. It's fine this week. She needs to go.
But darling, the Armstrongs from Haringway, they recommended her. You know they're worth at least 1,300,000.
By recent studies shows that over 7,580 people were recorded as rough sleeping in London in the years 2014 and 2015.
Pause.
I don't care where the recommendations have come from. She's not living up to my standards. She needs to go.
But darling, that's the fourth one this week.
By this number has increased every year since 2007 and is now more than double what it was in the early 2000s.
Mew.
But darling, you don't seem to realise. I know she's an immigrant. I know she's foreign, but you have to understand, her English is brilliant.
I don't care. I don't trust her or her type. Anyway, the Haringways are from... The Armstrongs are from Haringway. They're not from Essex.
I'm Mew, but that's all the time we've got for on the news. It's now 8:30 a.m. So for those of you who are late for work, you better get on your way.
Better get on my way.
Everybody!
please stop at the next station. Customers. They're asked, but passengers leave the train first. Please leave the train. Mind the gap, and thank you for travelling with London Underground.
Miss Jones, what are my appointments for today?
You seem to have Mark and Jules have been booked.
Sorry, Mark. Who is that?
He's the tired-looking one. Always has childcare issues. Blackberry, not Apple.
Oh, Blackberry, not Apple. Did you say Jules is waiting for me? Send him in.
Are you sure? You cancelled on Mark twice this week.
So? He can wait for a third.
Come on, I'm afraid you're going to have to wait.
Brad, nice
hey
to see
you. Hey, buddy,
ya.
How's it going? Are we still off for golf this afternoon?
Yeah, how's about 5:10? Sound okay to you?
Sounds great. Now, before you start, I've got something I want to run by you real quick. The boys down in the lab, they tell me that we've got to get a new server up and running for launch day. Now, they're looking at Intel i5 Ivy Bridge. What say you?
I don't like it, Brad. I want Haswell. You know what? No, I want Broadwell, and I want 2.7 gigahertz.
The boys in the lab, they say that the clock speed isn't up to spec.
Sorry, sir. I'm sorry.
Whoa. I'm pretty sure that, first of all, we were in a meeting. Second of all, have you heard of knocking? And third of all, it is rude to interrupt.
I'm sorry, sir. I'm having childcare issues.
Childcare issues? Do either of you two have childcare issues?
I'm sorry, sir. I'm having childcare issues. My wife, she's cancelled the nanny. That's the fifth one this week. And
Miss Jones, what's his name? Blackberry, not Apple. Mark, go get this on his file.
Thank you, sir. You won't regret this.
Brad, Jules, Miss Jones. Arses, you can see. Completely intolerant to Mark's troubles and pleas. I wonder how you, dear audience, would react in their place. Would his long service and dedication merely amount to shit and waste? The scene you have just witnessed is sadly repeated day upon day, and we are all left a-pondering on the audacious Brad's final say.
Take a letter, Miss Jones. Quote, I regret to inform you that owing to circumstances quite beyond our control, it's a premature retirement for those surplus to requirement. It's just another sign of the times, Miss Jones. A most miserable sign of the times. Take a letter, Miss Jones. Due to the world situation, the global slump, the shrinking pound. I'm afraid we must fire you. We no longer require you. It's just another sign of the times, Miss Jones. A most miserable sign of the times, Miss Jones.
There's a young man on the street, Miss Jones. He's walking around in circles. He's old before his time, but still too young to know. Don't look at him, don't cry though. This living on the gyro, it's only a sign of the times, Miss Jones.
Most unfortunate sign of the times, Miss Jones. The most miserable sign of the times, Miss Jones. The most unfortunate sign of the times, Miss Jones. Not a miserable sign of the times.
Mummy, I need some help with this homework.
You're a child yourself.
But it's really difficult. And last time you said that you would help me.
Wait for your dad to get home.
But he always takes ages.
Can Google it.
Hey, darling. I've got something I need to talk to you about.
You're late.
I'm sorry, but like I said, I've got something I need to talk to you about.
Yes, I need to talk to you as well. The extension needs extending, it's just not enough.
Darling, this is not big enough already.
No, more after my bathroom's done.
Darling, that's a lot of money.
Yes, we have the money to waste. I've also been looking out some holidays. I'm thinking the Maldives.
Darling, we need to make a lot of cutbacks. That is a lot of money.
Well, and your golf trips and stuff.
Darling, I don't think you're listening to me. We need to make a lot of cutbacks. Darling, I've been!
Expected. Her ignorance, it ruins his life. His wife, the trophy hunter, drops him straight away. How could she maintain her social standing? He really couldn't stay. Mark's capital, belongings, and livelihood that he once did possess. Dismantled by lawyers and accountants, the poor fellow became a real mess. Depression, it quickly shrouds him, fueled by drugs and pain. Friends, they abandon him, and Mark struggles to remain sane. Savings quickly consumed by extortionate London rates. Mark spiraled to disaster. Ends with homelessness as his fate.
I've been in the streets 23. Drinking, alcoholic, I've seen so much shit in my life, man. I've seen my best friends die in front of me. I've been stabbed on the streets. Yeah, I've had bricks across my head. I'm a bit crazy. I don't want to be crazy. It's a drink that's doing the drugs, you know? The people you lose and all you love.
Did you know, dear audience, that the property wealth in London, in the top 10 London boroughs, may I add, is more than Scotland, Northern Ireland, and Wales combined?
Did you know, dear audience, that according to Londoners themselves, East is poor, West is posh, North is intellectual, and South is dull?
Now, the only thing dull about that is the headline. Where is Balotelli with his hair on fire?
Did you know, dear audience, that Madame Tussauds in New York is £52, Madame Tussauds in Hong Kong is £27, but right here in London is £82?
Did you know, dear audience, that the politician, he promised me so many homes, only 60% of them went to me. Did you know, dear audience, that 7,000 homeless people live in London right now, and 31% of those people, they live in Westminster. Did you know, dear audience, that she spends on average about £40 on food? She can't even spend 10p, just 10 pence, just to put in my cup. Did you know, dear audience, that he could talk about so many things, important things, but instead he talks about this crap.
My life has been jumped off the tracks. Can't be with my family. That's one of the reasons I do like my refreshments.
I was kicked out of the house because I was no longer wanted by the government, no longer wanted by the family. I sit on my own, which was scary. I lived underneath bridges. I lived underneath stairways.
That's what being homeless is all about. It's all about money. You can't live without money.
Dreams of walking with giants, to carve his niche in the edifice of time, before the mortar of his zeal has a chance to congeal.
The cup is dashed from his lips.
The flame is snuffed, a warning.
He's brought to rack and ruin in his prime. He's brought to rack and ruin in his prime.